sun come up on the Spanish sea, our homeland far behind us, being hunted by the king's navy, but sure he'd never find us. Pull away, me lads, of the Cardiff Rose, and hoist the Jolly Roger.
During the millennia that men have hunted frogs, a pattern of hunt and parry has developed. The man, with net poised, creeps noiselessly, so he thinks, towards the frog, who sits very still and waits. The rules of the game require the frog to bide his time until the final flicker of a second, when the net is descending, and then jump into the water, swim to the bottom, and wait for things to blow over. This is the way it's done, the way it's always been done. Frogs don't resent this. But how could they have anticipated Mac's new method? How could they have foreseen the horror that followed?
Welcome to Life is Mimi, and today we're going to talk about utilizing the golden rule as concerns consciously creating your reality using what is known as the law of attraction, and everyone is you pushed down. These are the same things said differently. The law of attraction is like thoughts, beliefs attract like circumstances, conditions, events, and people into your life. And this is pulled from the law of vibration. And you vibrate in your heart what you believe about yourself and the world and others. It's your entire state of consciousness is vibrating, and you're changing it all the time. And that's why in the objective world, that the only constant in life is change. And what that is saying is the only law on the objective side, constant, is a law, it's a principle, is everything changes all the time. What the period of time that we're in is everyone is learning that you can swim both ways. You can consciously create or unconsciously create, up to you. Okay, but once you eat the pill, once you come to these teachings, the Napoleon Hills, the Secret, the Murphys, the Nevilles, and there's just so many of them, and they're all telling it their way. There's no two people are alike. No two blades of grass are alike. No two manifestations are alike. They're not. Each one is different, and beautiful in its own way. Okay, it's a piece of consciousness, but it's not like a piece pulled out of it because it's indivisible. There's a string, and it's beautiful. It's a beautiful, tapestry. And that's why we admire the tapestries of old. And You know, that's what we're doing. It's making this beautiful tapestry. And we're all doing it in our own way. And that's, so, you know, it's our color. You know, it's our song. It's our dance. You know, each one of us has our own. And then we bring them all together, you know. And by thinking the same way, but all the dances are different and all the songs are different. And it becomes this beautiful choir, this beautiful orchestra, this beautiful painting, you know, of humanity. So in order to get there, each one of us has to make our world, our reality, you know, reflect that everything is, you know, beautiful. Unity, harmony, and love. There's understanding and patience and kindness. And you're coming at it from the love side instead of the fear side. Now, when you read the Bible one way, and what a lot of people are caught up in is fear and doubt and guilt. So the fear side of it is, you know, well, if you imagine, you know, chopping off Harry's hand, it's your hand that's going to get chopped off, not Harry's. You know, that's the fear of God. You're afraid. You don't want your hand to get chopped off. But Harry's still a jerk. But you don't. I didn't think that. No, I didn't say that. I'm not going to chop his hand off. But he's a jerk. You're still playing the game. Okay? But the point is, you're going to get what you give. All right? And then you can look at it from the love side, the other side. Step away from the fear and the doubt and the guilt and look at it from the love side. At Harry, I don't care what comes out of his mouth. He is just wonderful. He's always so helpful. You know, he's just the best neighbor ever. And he's funny. He's just so funny. I mean, sometimes he just cracks me up, you know? And I like the way he loves the little kids. And he loves his dog. He does. He's the best, you know. I just love him. He's the best. And all the annoying things of that neighbor go away. And he starts showing you his best. He can't help it. Heart to heart talking. You're talking with love now instead of fear. And that was because of where humanity was at that point in time when it was written. You know, that's what they're reading into it. And then their preachers see it objectively and they go out there and preach, have the fear of God in you, fear the Lord, you know, but they don't explain what to be afraid of. And it's your thoughts, it's your beliefs. You know, you would never rob somebody or kill somebody or drive by and shoot somebody. You wouldn't even imagine it for most of us. But you've accepted that there are a few who do that. So God keeps showing that to you. You know? Don't accept that. No. No, they're released. You know, I didn't know. This is a game and humanity's playing it. And if you want your life to be great because we're aware of everything, you have to start shooting that stuff out to everybody. It's not okay to say, you know, I love these people, those people, horrible. They all need to go and die. You know, no. That person needs to fear the Lord, you know, because here it comes. Something's going to make you realize how stupid that thinking is. Then everybody will say hallelujah when you get over it. You know? The idea is stop being afraid of the Lord and start loving the Lord. Okay? Markets show this brilliantly. They climb a wall of worry. So they're worried, they're worried, they're worried. They're always looking over their shoulder. Oh my God, but what about this? What are the... We could do, but it just keeps going up. It just keeps going up. You know, but that, and you're running away from it. Oh, no. Then there's other people who are just like, Everything's looking pretty good. And then it gets to the top. And what happens at the top? I'll tell you what happens. The market's going to go up forever. It's a new paradigm. Ding, 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 ding. Sell. Sell. I don't care if it takes another year to fall. Sell. You know, it's not rocket science. And then what happens? All that shit you were afraid of while it rallied. Yeah, imagined it in. You know, those days are changing because the fear is being taken out. So the irony is that as the fear gets taken out, you know, we do enter a new paradigm. But it's about understanding that, you know, you can look at it with fear. Don't think like that. It's going to come bite you. Or, you know, take it to the next level. Don't think like that. It's going to bite you. Not only that, you're making somebody else do that to you. That's crazy. No. No, I love them all. And this is pulling the good and the bad together. And if you didn't notice, part of the 80s big deal was, why did the nice girls always go for the bad boys? They want to turn them. They want to change them. You know, why do the beautiful girls always love what they can't have? You know, because they want to get it no matter what. You know, and you would hear these things that, you know, and I would always say, that's not true. What are you talking about? But it was said a lot. And that's that, you know, you want to tame that beast. You want your love to do that. But when you see it objectively, you're being a victim bully. But when you see it subjectively, that now you're seeing it with love. And now it's moving beyond, you know, the golden rule, moving into the golden rule, which is the same thing. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. If you wouldn't kill anybody, then nobody else would either. Nobody. Okay? Nobody acts like that. Nobody thinks like that. That's so last century. No, I don't think so. And you just keep on trucking. And it will leave your consciousness. It may pop up a time or two because you believed it. You know, you saw it in TV shows, you saw it in movies. You were seeing it objectively. But when you use that ultimate mental diet, it truly does all the work for you in flipping your thinking from objective to subjective. And now you see it in a new light, and everything changes, and it's like a painting, you know, it shimmers. It's great. So I hope this helps. It's, you know, from that point on, you embrace the Shema, which is you understand that we're all one, and you love the one in you, and, you know, you love everyone. And everything, it's all gone, you know, so you love it all. And if you don't understand it, then you just say, well, I know there's good in there somewhere, I'm just not seeing it right now. You know, I know they're better than that, I know they're great, and you just keep on going. And you always step back for love, you know. People are trying to get you to make a judgment, and I don't care, as long as my special person is happy, then it's all good. It's all good to me. She's happy. I'm happy. We're all happy. It's all good. I love seeing her happy. I love seeing her happy. And guess what happens? All the guys who've been, and gals who've been fighting over your special person melt away. You know, and it's yours. Because you're willing to sacrifice yourself for their happiness. And you mean it. You mean it. What good is life without being happy? I love them, so I want them to be happy. You know, it breaks my heart if it doesn't want to be with me, you know, but I'm still thrilled that they're going to be happy and that somehow I made it better for them to be that way, you know, and poof, you know, you've dropped it, but you dropped it with love. Poof. Here it comes. It's great. So I hope this helps. Blessings to you. And thank you. Thank you for being you.
Why do you have to hurt people?
Oh, sometimes you have to.
No, you don't.
Well, he lied to me. He deserved it.
You know that's not the truth.
What, and you'd know?
Yeah, I do.